Originally, we wanted to call ourselves Ghostbusters. However, we discovered the people may confuse us with the popular and well-known Edinburgh tourist attraction, the Ghost Bus Tours.
Picture shown on the screen.
Just a reminder, any individual experiences at tonight's events are the intellectual property of the Ghostbusters PLC. No refunds. Our historian, Professor Conrad Forger, has discovered some information regarding King Richard III's connection to this village.
Thank you, Sarah. Following the execution of King Dick... Ricardo III.
Richard.
A renegade Lancastrian knight carved out the heart of the last Plantagenet, believing that Ricardo's soul was imprisoned in the mortal flesh. The knight, known as Sir Cromstangel, ventured towards Walton on Trent to escape and cross the River Trent, to escape from Leicester, to reach an unknown haven.
Did you mean Leicestershire?
He sadly caught swine flu, which was rife in those days, and with his dying breath buried the heart within a golden casket in this very spot, which in those days was a horse and cart park for the local alehouse called the White Swine. Irony. The village hall was then built upon top about 10 years ago.
This village hall has been here a lot longer.
Yes, thank you, Conrad. Now, our instruments support the base assumption that the ghost of King Richard is confined to this area, and sadly, we are unable to dig for the golden casket, which would fetch a fortune.
It belongs in a museum. It would be much easier just to dig it up.
You're not digging it up. Told me you can find another way.
Oh, yes, yes, there is another way. With our skill sets, we hope to commune with King Richard tonight, and with our scientific instruments, we can capture and relocate him to somewhere else, like Swaddling Coat. Our various instruments can locate and capture spirits. Digging up a golden casket won't help. The remnants of the human heart would surely perish. That's why the soul, I mean, whatever that is confined to here.
Actually, sir, it would have perished a long time ago, as King Richard died about 14 years ago, when he was 85 years old. That is why he's presented as an old man.
So, 14 years ago? He died in
1485.
What did you qualify
Adam, for? Adam, you know this is freestyle, but I cannot see his face. Your leg is blocking him when he's talking. I'm talking about a video. Don't listen to me, people. This is just behind the scenes.
Moving on.
There you go.
Let me introduce our moral compass in tonight's proceedings and saviour of our souls, Father O'Dreary, who actually is the local vicar here. Quite convenient. Dan. Where is he? Well, I suppose. Okay, this is Verity Duvec. Now, she has a very different theory on how we can commune with the dead. She believes in the power of love and what? Stop looking at me like that. Okay. She believes in the dark arts, whatever that means. No, I'm not going to ask him for some blood. I've told you, I'm not mentioning that tonight. Nor am I asking him to take his clothes off. Just sit down, Verity. You're scaring the straits. No, sit down over here. Conrad, take over.
Yes. Buy my book. Yes, buy my book. My book. It's called How I Found the Titan, Nick.
Right, well, what's it about?
It's not about 400 pages. It's actually 427. You may recall that in 1997, the famous ship, the Titan, Nick, went missing. I was impressed that they managed to find some eyewitness footage by someone called Leonardo DiCaprio. Now, I couldn't watch it to the end. It was too long. But I understand that Leo actually dies when the old lady threw him at the end of the boat. Sad times. However, I have evidence that he is actually alive as a wolf in Wall Street. Well, I managed to find him and, well, I found clues to the location of the Titan, Nick, without giving too much of the book away. I personally transported it, the ship, brick by brick from Buxton. See, lots of people think it was actually made of icebergs, but it was brick. No wonder it sank.
What the hell has this got to do with King Richard III and getting rid of him? Also, the Titanic was a film in 1997 from the famous ship disaster in 1912. What are you even on
about? No, I saw the copyright.
It was a film, not a documentary. There's other films about the Titanic, like Raise the Titanic, done in 1979/1980.
No, you're wrong. Raise the Titanic was actually about anthropomorphic boats playing poker. I should know. I have a double first in history at the University of Tamworth.
Whose cars are out front?
I can't decide who is worse, left side, right side.
Oh, well.
Just don't die, man.
Oh,
my Lord.
It's taken me ages to get here. First, I had to have a gentle word with some bloke wandering the church grounds looking for Pokemon.
Ah, Father O'Dreary, I told you. The parish council can't stop people from going onto church property, and neither can you.
It's absolutely disgusting that these bloody Valor people...
No, it's not Valor, is it?
It's Mystic.
Mystic people keep coming in.
I got a question, though. This is my line you're doing, right? Or has it changed?
No?
Okay, calm down.
Changing the gym. You mark my words, they will have an issue. And secondly, I couldn't park outside, so I had to walk all the way from the rectory.
Yeah, isn't that just around the corner? Oh, never mind. I'm glad you're here. You can help keep the holy peace. Well, just keep an eye on Verity.
Why do I always have to look after that little spawn of Satan? Can I say a few words before we begin this ghost hunt?
Sure, that's fine. Keep it short.
Before we begin, I want to point out the church's views on all of this. According to Ezekiel 23:21, she lusted after lovers with genitals as large as babies and emissions like a horse. That's the wrong page. Where is it? Oh, here it is. 37. The hand of the Lord was on me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me in the middle of the valley. It was full of bones. He led me back and forth among them. And I saw a great many bones on the floor of the valley, bones that were very dry. He asked me, Son of man, can these bones live? I said, Sovereign Lord,
I just want to sing.
you...
That's
what it's based on.
But that's what I want to say.
Wow.
You alone know. Now, I think that's pretty clear on the church's stance. For tonight's proceedings.
God
tonight's proceedings.
Only knows.
Don't blaspheme. Don't blaspheme. Thank you, I ain't got the editing. Don't blaspheme!
Introduce yourself.
Oh, the better. Who's next?
Claire, introduce yourself.
Oh, hello, my name is Claire.
Yeah, can you talk about what you actually do with the Ghost Dusters?
Hello, my name is Claire, and I have a gift.
Yeah, you've got a few minutes to fill here.
Right, okay. Look at me. What do you think I can do?
I'll do it. Mind reading.
No, not mind reading.
Levitation.
No, not levitation or mind reading.
A face painting.
Oh, shut up, Dan. You know what I can do. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I can read the future.
Yes. How do you go about that?
Tarot cards, glazing into crystal balls, palmistry, etc., etc.
Superstitious, blasphemous rubbish. Where is the evidence of all this?
I don't know, he's not going to say evidence, by the way.
Damn, let her speak.
Look, I'm not sure I've got a tea bag, didn't I? Look, I have a tea bag here. I can show you tea bagging.
Claire, I think you mean tea leaf reading. What you said there is something very different.
I wish you didn't tell me what that is.
Oh, I'll tell you what it is, Dawn.
No, you don't want to know. We'll tell you after.
Okay. Because I don't know what that is. Right, what does it mean? I only meant reading the... Oh, never mind. Let me read someone's tarot cards. Oh, I sense there's an aura around you. I foresee that you'll be here tonight.
Of course I was going to be here tonight. You knew that. I hired you.
Oh, right. Let's see what's in. Now, this is the past. Ooh, the Emperor. You clearly were in a position of power in the past.
Well, I was a police officer.
Oh, fascinating. Now, this is your present. The tower. Not quite sure what that one means, so we'll come back to that one. Now, this is the force that's working against you, the devil. Now that sounds bad. Look, like someone has it in for you. Perhaps revenge of something you might have done in your past.
No, I don't know what.
Oh dear, your future. Oh, it's death.
That doesn't sound very... promising. How does it?
Well, this is silly.
It is.
I've had enough of this. You're all frauds. None of you have a clue what is going on. Sarah, I think you're only here to con these good people out for their money with some nonsense. Go on, out you get.
That is ridiculous. Why would I con anybody out of any money? Oh my God,
ladies and gentlemen, I apologise for this complete farce.
Where's this toilet? It just doesn't
I have no idea what this group is a bunch of complete frauds.
Time.
That historian and clairvoyant, they're just making it up as they go along. And the vicar.
This is modern Elizabethan.
It's changed, actually.
Okay.
What are you doing up there?
Well, hey. What are you doing up there?
Hey, what are you doing?
And what's that in your hand?
Fine.
Pew! Pew, pew!
Oh, he got dead.
Bang.
No, Now, look here. We have all decided that we're owed some money. Or at least I have decided. These people have paid, so I think we should get some money for being here tonight. We could have been elsewhere.
Oh, you've run out of toilet paper, and I need some food. And really, I'm not getting kicked out of my own village's hall. Where's that Saxon? I shall have words with him.
That's another extra, isn't it? Are you trying to hold it in this time or what?
She's dead! I knew it! Actually, I got it right. I did it! I knew I could!
Yeah, man.
That sounds almost like a confession to me. But I think it's far too early to see. It would appear that I've arrived at the right time, for this looks like a foul crime. A murder.
Murder? Who said anything about a murder?
I do, my dear, but fear not, for a gun did fire. But I will find the liar, for one of you has committed a crime, and with my detective skills I shall unravel with a rhyme.
Can you speak normally? Because it's giving my headache.
Are you saying we're suspects in a murder?
That is correct.
Just go.
I saw the whole thing. You've all been in the wrong place at the wrong time. Or perhaps the right place. Each one of you has been acting suspiciously tonight. And all of you were out of the room when the murder took place. Which would suggest that the six of you...
I am now fled by detective. There is only five of us.
The five of you...
Now. He always gives 20% more.
And now suspects to a murder inquiry.
Of course I'm not, because I'm a man of God. Somebody call the proper police.
Ah, oh, my friends, you are in the presence of champagne truffle. So...